wanted to check in, see how you're doing. That one Duke Ellington song came on one of my playlists, and I thought of you. Well, I mean, I thought of Travis, but that made me think of you. Just call me when you get the chance. I miss you.
Congrats on Cornish! We brought cake.
Oh, guys, you shouldn't have.
About the same as last time.
I don't think that's as comforting as you think it is. When was last time?
Like 2 months ago?
Well, are you doing anything new? I'm sure not everything's the same.
You know that old dance place that you used to go to, Holly's Dance? Well, they needed a bookkeeper and they knew that we were in that math club together with Miss Fitzgerald freshman and sophomore year, so they emailed me and now they're paying me under the table.
God, that's so funny. I miss that place. Tell Miss Hirschlag I say hi.
Of course.
Are you still saving up for that one art school? I can't remember the name of it still.
Eindhoven. And no, not really. I've kind of taken a permanent break from art. I guess I've just lost motivation. But anyway, how are you? Is Seattle everything you dreamed of?
Well, we're going to come back to the art thing later because I think that you should keep doing it, but... Oh my god, yes, Seattle is everything and more. It's so amazing. Cornish is so much fun, but it's really hard, and I'm definitely, definitely improving, but we spend sometimes 9 hours a day just learning dance, and my body's not quite used to that.
Haven't found a jazz club yet, but it was on the top of my Seattle bucket list. I've been putting it off. It feels... almost sacrilegious now.
A jazz club? I forgot about that.
That's the most important thing that is...
I didn't just forget about the jazz club. Come on now, I just... guess I haven't thought about it since Chicken on a Stick closed.
It closed?
What happened?
I talked to King about it, and he said that the only way they were able to stay afloat was because Travis had gotten his parents to help out with operating costs.
What? They didn't even pay for him to take piano lessons. Why would they fund an entire jazz club for him?
That's what I was thinking, but I don't know. I guess they just have a soft spot for jazz or something. They can definitely afford it, though.
Wow, I guess I left at the right time. Everything sounds so empty now.
State your name.
Brandon. Full name. Brandon Anthony Murdoch.
Ew, Murdoch?
Shut up.
What's your favorite piece you've made?
Probably the big one. It's not technically my best or anything, but I don't know, I just like it. The colors and abstractions speak to what I like, I guess.
What's been on your mind lately?
I really don't know. Actually, I was watching The Labyrinth the other day, and I was listening to Hozier afterwards, and I was thinking, what if they made a modern reboot or retelling, but they replaced Bowie with Hozier? It just seems so much more mystical, you know?
That's actually... Wow, I wasn't expecting that.
You didn't think I was that smart?
No, I thought you were smarter.
Whatever.
I don't know why, I just always think toast with butter on it will be the most decadent thing I've ever tried.
See, I don't understand how you can say all that when you know that bagels exist.
Bagels?
Congrats on Cornish!
We brought cake.
Oh, guys, you shouldn't have.
Well, we gotta eat the rest of the cake, so it's a win-win.
You weren't supposed to tell her that.
Well, either way, I'm glad you guys came. I wasn't sure I was gonna see you before I left.
That's ridiculous. We would never let you go to Seattle without saying goodbye.
We would literally stalk your plan.
What kind of friends do you think we are?
Just look at these shots I got.
These are really good. It does remind me, though, I'd be meaning to ask, why are all your shots always in black and white?
I don't know. It's so much simpler, you know? If I could live in black and white, I 100% would.
Hey, remember those letters he wrote us?
Of course, but I still haven't read mine, though.
Why not?
I don't know. I guess I'm just scared. On? How do I tell if it's on?
Is the record button down? What are you doing?
Okay, it's recording. State your name.
Travis Crabtree.
Crabtree? Gross.
Shut up, Murdoch.
What's been on your mind lately?
The big question.
You know it.
I've been thinking a lot about storefronts lately. They're so imposing. You know?
What?
No, they are. Like, I'd look at all these buildings downtown, you know, and I just, like, never go in, never know what's inside. It's like they were set pieces in my life. I had no idea how much I was missing. There's a jazz club literally 4 blocks away. Did you know that?
No.
Me neither. It's called Chicken on a Stick, and they play jazz every night, and old women come in, and they dance with their husbands, and they just meet up with friends, and it's really, really beautiful. They open at 5 p.m. and close at 5 a.m. For all 12 hours, you just feel alive. And not just alive, but alive in a way that I've never felt before. When I go into that club, I feel like George Lucas must have felt at the rap party for the first Star Wars movie. I'm there, and I'm dancing and having fun with people I feel truly connected to. It feels like family. And we all know something great's happening, but we don't know how great it is until we all look back on it. We're too caught up in the feeling of it all.